the regular meeting of the Dublin Salmon Health Services District Board of Directors. Director Duarte is participating in this meeting via telephone, so all votes taken this evening will be done by roll call vote. Presiding this evening is President Juan Peter Leopold.
Call the meeting to order, please stand and join me in the salute to our flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Nicole?
Director Halkin?
Here.
Director Howard?
Here.
Director Duarte?
Here.
Vice President Mishawak?
Here.
President Juan Peter Leopold?
Here.
Any special announcements or activities?
Yeah, we just wanted to report, we put the lid on our board digester. And I'm going to give you a video clip for the second meeting to work here. It's really cool. You know, here, logging in.
Yeah.
Referring their eyes.
On the poster.
Yes, yes.
So this was set up to make it easier.
Easy, yeah.
That's logical. That's logical.
Your cap locks, your cap locks. That's, it's on. Your cap locks.
Reminds me of when my computer says, you don't have rights to do this.
Yeah.
I paid for you, I have the rights, yes.
Exactly. Contact your administrator.
I am the administrator. Who else do you want me to call?
Right.
But where, do you know where it was stored, Nicole? So you can log in and see this is you.
Just do guess your guessy. No, then you can't get up the screen. Yeah.
Oh, and then you have to do password.
This is awesome.
I know.
Well, it's better than beat it.
See why I like paper?
Keep the video.
Don't need a video.
Beth likes paper, so we're printing out the...
That's right.
The what?
The article.
Yeah, don't muck yourself out.
I mean, it was sort of...
That'd be unfortunate for your people.
I think we'd qualify. Okay, control.
I'm sure it's not this.
Well, it would only have to be speaking.
What do you need here?
It's broken.
Yes.
Yes.
I'd send you that.
I guess it likes you better, Steve.
Mom loves you.
Hi.
Do you have any other announcements that we can move you on?
It was the last time you logged in.
Oh, God.
This is like to probably order the agenda.
I could give you...
Oh, that was bad.
It must be missing a lot of fun there.
Well, we're outwitting a computer.
We're attempting to.
Did I go the right one to call?
Part of the correct one, but it doesn't look like. Did I see? No, you're not the board. You could go to presentations and board. Go back to presentations. VOD.
Oh, there you go.
VOD.
Woo.
6-5.
I need glasses.
No, we don't have to. So you'll see it at the next board meeting.
I saw a picture of it.
Yeah. And actually, I saw the clip on my email. So.
I saw it on YouTube. It was really cool.
Saw it on YouTube. It's cool.
Yeah.
I'll try to find it.
6-5, we received presentation on that skill.
That's fair.
Okay, other than that, moving right along.
All right. Sorry about that.
Any other special announcements?
No, just some event calendar stuff.
Okay.
The East Bay Leadership Council Water Task Force is meeting on June 19th. It's normally held up in Mullet Creek, but we're holding the monthly event. Hosted here in Dublin at Dublin City Hall on June 19th at 8 o'clock. It's a presentation, actually, on the Tri-Valley Joint Portable Reuse Feasibility Study. It's a chance for the business community to get up to speed on that. There's nothing new in that presentation you haven't already read or heard before. If you'd like to make some rub elbows with folks, have a chance to go, but I'm not gonna, we've shared most of the information with you already. There is a Central Stand liaison meeting on June 20th at Central Stand at 8 a.m. There's a chance two of you, the External Affairs Committee, are attending that. If anybody wants to carpool, let us know and we'll do so. If not, we'll see you at Central Stand. The Tri-Valley Mayor's Summit is on August 15th. Early registration is a must because that sells out. It's a chance to mix with elected officials and other Tri-Valley agencies. Livermore is on the rotation, of course, this year. And we're planning a liaison meeting with City of Pleasant on August 23rd in Pleasanton. We anticipate having an external affairs meeting in advance of this meeting to strategize on some key DSRS points to make. And those are our events. We do have some board correspondence. You have an email, I think, with each of you. Somebody thanking us, Richard Jesse, about the Citizens Water Academy.
Okay. Now let's move on to public comment.
Thank you, Mr. President.
This is the time when any member of the public can address the board on any item that's not included on the agenda. I don't think we have any public in the audience. Okay, let's move on then to 6A. We already went through the event calendar and the correspondence. Everybody's seen the JPA minutes from LAVMA. Do the representatives have anything to add?
No, budget was approved.
Okay.
Let's move on.
Agenda management, do we have anything we need to move around? Yeah, imagine we do. Okay, the consent calendar. This consent calendar are usually non-controversial and can be considered in one motion.
I'll second.
It's been moved and seconded that we approve the consent calendar. Nicole?
Director Hoffman?
Yes.
Director Howard?
Aye.
Director Duarte?
Aye.
Vice President Mishawak?
Aye.
President Javier Leopold?
Aye.
The motion's been passed unanimously with no oppositions and no abstentions. Let's move on then to board business, item number 8. 8A, receive presentation of primary sedimentation expansion and improvement projects.
So thank you, members of the board. This is
and update on our primary certification expansion improvement projects. So a brief overview of where our primaries are at. This is located in this red box here. We have four existing primaries that are ours, 1, 2, 3, and 4. They're located just south of our digesters. This is where digester number 4 is currently under construction. And then this is building A, and here are our aeration basins and facility basins. So when we receive wastewater, it comes through this building here through our bar stream and makes its way over through our existing roof removal tanks that remove sand and gravel and other small heavy materials. And then from there, the wastewater travels into our primary clarifiers. So in the primary clarifier, what they do is the wastewater flows to our four rectangular tanks here. And the tanks are used to settle out sludge or suspended solids. And while using oil kind of rise to the top of those are still off. So here's a short video showing how our existing clarifiers work. What you see here is this is where the wastewater comes in. The sprayers help break that apart, reducing the back and top. And what you don't see is actually underneath the water where we have the mechanically driven scrapers that collect the suspended solids that drop down and move down toward the hopper closer to where the input comes in. As you make your way down the clarifier, comes in through these weirs and exits the waters through these waters over to our aeration basins. So as part of the wastewater treatment plant master plan that was recently completed last year, the primaries were to be committed to the underperforming and that they should be looked at for expansion up to about 3 tanks of similar size to maximize performance. The expansion of the 3 tanks, though, if you were to place them immediately next to our existing tanks, would start to encroach into our access road here and also take part of holding basin number 1. So we wanted to do a more thorough analysis to see if there were other options with how to maximize our existing primary and the location. As part of the master plan, it was also recommended that we look at the efficiency of our existing primaries and the efficiency of our grid tanks, which is, you can see with these white moves right here, there's 3 of them. So last year, the board approved West Coast Associates to begin analysis of the existing primaries, and the staff has met with them over the last couple of months. Operations agreements, and we've had a lot of good discussions on what we could do to improve this area. We also had West Coast do some performance evaluation testing on the existing primaries and good tanks. The conclusion was that we could build a new tank number 5, which would actually be deeper than the existing tanks. And then we could also at the same time have tank number 1 demolish that and make it similar to tank number 5. So that you would have 2 new deeper tanks next to the 3 existing primary tanks. And this option would save on space and maintain our access road and would provide, with the deeper tanks would also help with settling out solids and maybe consider, would help us with capacity for the future. So during the performance testing, it was determined that our existing primaries was performing about 39 to 40% of efficiency of removing the total suspended solids. So that means that most of our suspended solids is actually making its way through the primaries to the aeration basins and secondary clarifiers, which causes those downstream operations to work harder and require more energy. So to improve our efficiency, we would need to modify, not only would we need to add the existing, but the new tank 5 and make the changes to tank number 1, should also modify tanks, the existing tanks, 2, 3, 4. And then that would help remove additional suspended solids. By doing that, you actually would receive more sludge to the light fixtures, creating more energy, and it would be less of a burden on the aeration needs and needs that we have. During the testing, we also had, Westfield also took a look at our drip tanks. We found that we were actually receiving 50% more drip than was typical at a treatment plant. So that excess drip can also cause our system primaries to work harder, and it caused the mechanical equipment to break down a lot faster. So the design recommendation for that would be to add another drip tank and to look at how we can improve our existing tanks. So this slide shows our existing in black, and in red is what we need to modify. So here would be where we could place our new drip tank number 4, which would be next to the new primary tank number 5. The additional drip tank number 4 would actually help us with influent flow splitting. So now you would have 2 tanks on each side. The tanks feeding tanks 2, 3, and 4, and then these drip tanks would be feeding tanks 1 and 5. And that would help us balance out the flow at that location. The drip tanks also need to have the pumps to be upsized. Since right now our existing pumps are undersized and are not able to move the existing drip fast enough. So the internal modifications that we need to have then, this would be tanks 2, 3, 4, and this is tanks 1 and 5, so this is a little bit different. We would need to replace all our the flighting chains, which would help us with moving the flows in the tank. We would add baffles, which are these lines here that we're straight down. What those do is they would knock down the suspended solids as it flows in this direction, and then it would drop down and go with the flighting chain to the hopper. So that will help slow things down, because right now we don't have these baffles in, this, in our primaries. The launders would also be shortened. Right now our launders come all the way up to this location, I believe. So by shortening the launders and making them perpendicular to the flow rather than their current location parallel, will increase the settleable time for the solids, which will help us remove additional solids. So then that will increase the efficiency of our existing launders. So because of all these changes, then I'm sure you're wondering about the cost. So due to the modifications of the original construction and project cost was $10 million, and that was for adding 3 additional tanks. That cost can cover the 2 deeper tanks, tanks 5 and 1. But however, if you want to maximize our efficiency, we need to include changing out the tanks 2 through 4, and add drip tank number 4, as well as the changes to the updated existing drip tanks. So then that would be an increase of what we estimate about 5 million. So a more accurate construction cost obviously would be available once design is completed and is up to date and within bids next spring. So how is our funding? We have 85% of this project that is currently funded by the Regional Wastewater Expansion. What you can see from this blue line here, which is our working capital, is that it is actually increasing over time. So we should be in good shape as far as funds for this project. The rest of the project, which is 15% of it, will be funded through the Regional Wastewater Expansion. And that is also in similar shape where it's increasing over time. Now, do you have any questions?
Is that you, Jackie?
Yes, it is.
2 questions on the initial study. When the testing was completed, we found out that we received more grit than a typical plant. Was there any thought as to why? I'm just curious why that private, I mean, we're in an urban area, a semi-urban area, and why do you think, or do you know, why we're getting more brick than the typical plan?
There's some speculation that it could be because of all the construction and development that might be making its way into our sewer system. And it also could be that our pumps are undersized and we're not able to remove the grid as fast as we could.
So some sand and fill type particles are getting into the system and coming downline into the feet of the tank.
Correct.
And then second, why, well, on the workings of the tanks themselves, the equipment, it was also found to be operating at less than efficient capacity. So I'm assuming there is just simply the age of the equipment and it's not exactly state of the art either, is that correct?
Well, it's the configuration. So the configuration of the piping change would actually change from what it is currently. The way it was recommended would allow us to add baffles, which will help with allowing the suspended solids to be knocked down sooner before it gets to the meters and the launders.
Yeah, I'm familiar with those. Our company installed baffles with the said tanks as for simple sand. It does improve the efficiency. So I'm glad you're doing that. When you looked at Joe's proposal for the amount of costs, you're satisfied with the number of hours that has to be reasonable in covering the additional work?
Yes. Because we would need additional structural work to be looked at for the additional tank.
Yeah, and then actually you're also going to be doing some an upgrade to the HVAC system in the building.
That's correct. So the existing MCC building, I believe, is quite old, and I'm not sure how old the HVAC system is, but I know that our operations and maintenance staff has had issues with it, especially during the hot summer days where they're not able to keep the room cool enough.
I'm pleased with the presentation. Thank you.
Is the higher the normal amount of grid before our tanks or after our tanks? Do we have more coming into the system than we expect, or do we have more coming out of our tanks than we expect? Other tanks are.
It's coming in from before.
Okay, so.
Well, as far as we know.
So that's what kind of confused me, because then we start talking about tank efficiency, pump efficiency, you know, problem. Do we have more stuff coming in that we're expecting, we have an upsize, or do we have a bad process that's not degraded enough? Or is it both?
I think it's a little bit of both. We have a lot of grid coming in, and then our pumps are, I don't know how old they are, but they're not up to standard.
So just a, I mean, we never have to give this again, but you may want to hit that point slightly differently. It's like, one, we have a problem if we have more stuff coming into our plant than we expect given our start of the plant. And two, we have a process problem that we're trying to fix this, which I totally support. I was confused trying to figure out whether we have one or the other.
We could take the time to try to chase down.
No.
But we decided that it's probably another few.
I'm getting that a lot.
Especially if
the pumps are that old. How, and then how old are the 2, 3, 4?
Those are built, I believe, over the stages 3 and stage 3, I think, which is around the 1980s.
And then, one last thing. How do you stage, and what comes out to actually do this? We're going to blow a new one. Take one offline and make it totally different by making it deeper and put the guts in the 3 buffers. So, do you have staging problems or are we going to deal with any guys? Is that going to be
a conversation? We had a conversation about that today.
We're in the process of trying to work out the construction schedule so that the provide the least amount of money to stop, which is, but we are trying to see what we can to get the operation.
Is it a winter project or a summer?
It'll be at least a year and a half.
So the problem will be harder than the winter?
About the same, I mean, the challenges in the winter is dealing with storm flows, so you'd like to have all the things in the service. And then the challenge for it in the summer is not having all the grid tanks may impact the quality of our outdoor and challenge our operating neighbors. But I feel pretty comfortable that we can come up with a contingency plan for both winter and summer operations.
Yeah, I'd like to make a suggestion, something that very, very few agencies do. On something in a complicated project like this, with the logistics involved in taking tanks out of service and trying to make the workflow work, I would strongly suggest you talk to OGRA, the GSE, or anyone else that has done this kind of work and ask for input, because the contractor says it's better than putting the job out to bid and extending the schedule and doing your milestone events. But if you're not a contractor, you really don't have the full grasp of what things can be done, and quite often having contractor input during the design stage will help a lot in making the job go smooth after bid and award.
They're not in their heads.
When do you hope to have this project started?
Well, by spring we should have this open. So then it will take some time to mobilize. So most likely we'll start the summer next year.
Excellent. Any other questions?
So for tonight's purposes, all we're doing is authorizing the task force, so we get design going and do the rest of the project.
It's probably going to be early end of that bond. That's going to be important.
I'll make a motion that we authorize amendment one, task order number one, with the Westios contract to design these sanitation tank expansion improvements.
I'll second that.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that we approve the request for an increase, an amendment to the task order number two. All those in favor?
It's amendment one task order.
Amendment one task order.
Yes.
Okay.
Director Hawkins?
Yes.
Director Howard?
Aye.
Director Forte?
Aye.
Vice President Schwab?
Aye.
President Linda Leopold?
Aye.
Okay, the motion passes. No abstentions and no objections. Let's move on to item 8B. Approved mid-year operating budget adjustments for fiscal year 2019 and 2020.
Snyder's talking to the budget adjustment, which for us is mid-year of 2 years between two operating budgets. And staff has reviewed the budget to date. And talked to all the departments. Revised budgets for up and down in program 2018 and then also 2019. And I'll be walking through that. Those budgets basically are in operating building for the current year, other ones in transit services. We have no adjustments to the revenue budget, and I'll be walking through this. Our first major carry the special request. If these are requests that have already approved by the board, we need to that we can consult with staff and have the time to finish it by the evening. We're asking if it comes to carry over to 2019. And those are basically two requests before you. They are on study going on right now, but we're studying the content. Possibly provider, or we can get to service providers and one nationwide and one place in the day. But we want to make sure that our participants in that program, whether it's not just people, have the best options to get the best services that we have the best options for higher quality. We are also looking at the local and regional study that is in process, and it will take about 2 months to finish that study so that we can do this also very early. Our third area for caring for women is with our troop fund asset management replacement model. That project has not been started yet, but we will be starting to this year on $192,000 total. Appropriation approved by the board last year. Putting it back into the capital balance section for the appropriated next year. Our second area of budget requests are new budget requests. So, I always tell people a budget is within the day you make it, and then something happens the next day, maybe not so good. But one of the things that wanted to make sure that our know is that they're going to do the best job possible and don't want them to be necessarily constrained with the budget. And so if they need something, we need something for the community, we have to use it. So we ask all departments to review the budget. In fiscal year 2019, there were $20,049,000 in additional requests. And these were primarily around the areas of interest, and overtime associated with the years, about $426,000. Because we had heightened development activity, we had to supplement our existing inspection staff and contractors, that's $325,000. We had great tank cleaning, the first OFA plus that we talked about before, going to a different scenario as far as investment, which started to return based on investment for more safety. That was possible to do that. And then at the cost, the nice thing about this year is because you guys push staff turnover and it takes HR time to recruit and replace their position, we have identified that this is a year that's $650,000 in salary benefits across the district. And we also went back and looked at other operations that we could possibly save money in the district and we would spend those funds and step in love with that $795,000 savings this year. So we're actually bottom line up in the room to
So we're unable to fill this in to the second department. And you're not looking to the next week?
Well, we budget as if every employee is here for 12 months. And so if I have someone that leaves, it generally takes about 3 months to recruit that position anywhere in the place. So we have salary savings throughout the district and we can be placed in the effort to maintain employees.
What would be a 25 million
this year? So out of that 121, that's the pre-existing option we have up to 3 months wide, which is somewhat
less than the year. So they're predicting for zero for this year. And you're kind of stabbed on the split.
We're that we have the budget, I know we'll have additional retirement, because we have a lot of retirement, but I don't know what it would be. And so I would rather wait until the beginning of the year, and that, that gives me hopefully, instead of relying on it. I don't know where the reasons happen. And so to, if we were all just a general fund, to be able to do what we are, and not the budget. In 2019, we again have about 1,000 additional requests. And then we could have 3.5 million that we talked about, the bond that was created for the, which we do have in the university, so.
Hang on, what we have of the bond, and the debt? I said that we need $3,000.
It will, it will. So it's a good economic move, and I think the board, maybe choose their, this is simply just the budget, so we have the recommendation to do that. And these additional, amounts that we can keep done on these, and that is, these communities, and these, there's a lot of costs to be hired. So we have a lot of big study, and especially we're looking at talking on our, issue with early value in that study, so we're just getting more out of staff and consulting we have. We also have landscape and city improvement, we need to make these costs. Again, we need to set the costs. The additional contract inspection, which we need our city, that we still don't have to supplement, because we're still in activity. And other small requests. We do have a savings measure and debt service, because we do the municipal funding of debt, that's $300,000. And that we will be monitoring that closely, so if we bring back other savings, having to make sure that we budget that. And then our third area of adjustment is in our capital outlay request. We have three requests here. One is for our CCTV equipment truck. We were supposed to modify our existing truck, which was pretty old. This year we didn't get around to it. Staff was still up to do that, and use that as the secondary vehicle. So we can perform, work out in the field, but also, in our projections, we have a new truck projected in this order in 2020. But to roll that forward to 2018, we should be able to get home to the side of the day. So we're asking for additional appropriation plus the carryover. Also, because we added a lot of new staff in FOF, we have the vehicles for all of them, so we're asking for, one additional Ford F-150 and a new Ford F-250 for our leasing and electrician that is just trying to leave. So those are our improvements. And then finally, as you know, we are watching very closely our local wastewater operating fund. And one of the things in the budget adoption was we were trying to make sure that we were ramping up our equipment allocation transfers from our ratepayers, from fund development community to ratepayers as we are looking at the development. And we end up to this fund is not in good shape until we can actually see the benefits of the primary increases. Staff is recommending a strategy to reduce those transfers of charges this year and by 50% this year. So that the money will stay in the local fund and will be left in the budget. So in total, the good news, if you look at page 61, this is by fund. A lot of the funds are actually being adjusted downwards, especially our local wastewater fund, which is where we really need to have those adjustments right now. And bottom line is we will have a credit back to the working capital for 18 additional amounts in 19 because I'll be happy to answer any questions that you might have. And then we will discuss these changes with the management team as well.
Quick question on the CCTV trust. So we have one, we wanted to do an upgrade here, we may get to it this year, about $409,000. We're going to buy a new one, $515,000. Not only possibly spend $109,000 on redoing an old truck, but we're going to buy a new one for $415,000.
That's a good question, that being my next one, probably, I heard it.
I think we can gladly spring the extra $6,000 for the two new trucks.
Go down.
I'm sure I'm missing something.
So, in our wastewater collection system, there's a couple of things that are happening currently. You know, we're out there cleaning the pipes, so the pipe flushing, you know, actually behind it, and picking up the camera footage and seeing what the distance it is. And the results of that footage is forwarded to our engineering folks, and they fix this for us, and then we put those things. Well, what we found is that we can clean the pipes a lot faster from behind them and capture the footage. So that, as we're rolling ahead with the clean, which we really need to do to make sure that it's clear, there's a gap forming behind when we come behind the TV footage stuff. So there's two things that are happening. One, we need an additional capability, because with one truck, all it takes is for one camera to go down and that truck's down and that gap widens even further. And so there are times when we'll need to be running two trucks concurrently to be able to catch up, and other times when you're going to take one truck down, you know, it's on it. At the pace that we're moving, it was really too difficult to take that truck down long enough to do the upgrades required. So we decided, okay, one truck really isn't enough. Two, at this stage, is maybe a bit more, but a new truck, while keeping the other to handle breakdown, the upgrades, is going to allow us.
So the 109 is for repairing and replacing and upgrading two trucks.
So of course, the majority of that goes towards the new truck.
That's 115.
So there's some carryover that we brought from the upgrade that is beyond what the upgrades are required. So the upgrades are not equal to the new truck. So if we look at the carryover request, the original appropriation strictly for the upgrades only was about $75,000. And that was a little on the high side. We probably don't need to spend that much. We had some other savings from capital we carried over that we didn't spend a little bit of that. So that sort of gives the portion that a lack. So the truck is going to be somewhere in the $200,000 range, and then the upgrades to the existing truck would be somewhere, I don't know exactly, so I don't care to get into this, somewhere in the $30,000 to $40,000.
So from the presentation, so this is clearly a presentation right now. So
correct.
The decrease in 18 showed, I had two lines. One for the 75 coming off of off the repair, and another for the 50 of found money.
Right.
And then the ask for 19 was the 75 for the repair, and then 150 for
the story better.
Have you learned something today?
You know,
take that fully to God.
Bottom line is, we have a refurbished truck and a brand new truck for total cost of saving, which I totally support. I was just curious.
And I'll just also add that in the previous presentation about the mystery about where we're getting excess grit, that we have two CCTV trucks that may.
You can find it.
Uncover that.
Absolutely.
And that grit may go away in 10 years.
So if I'm reading this, because we have a darn near a net decrease for 2 years if you take out the debt. This is easy.
Anybody else have any questions?
Actually, we took down a question or something.
Okay, we need to adopt the resolution approving the new year operating budget adjustments for fiscal year 2018 and 2019.
So moved.
I'll second.
I'll second.
Ken, second.
It's been moved and seconded that we adopt the resolution approving the mid-year budget, operating budget adjustments for fiscal years ending 2018 and 2019. Nicole?
Director Hallett?
Aye.
Director Howard?
Aye.
Director Forte?
Aye.
Vice President Schwab?
Aye.
President Barker Leopold?
Aye. It's been unanimously approved. There were no abstentions and no objections. Okay. Board member items. None from you? None there?
None.
How about you? Ed?
Yeah. Just a minor item. The last Friday of every month, Mayor Bill Clarkson has a breakfast at Clementine's. Both Dan and myself attended. It was more of he was looking for input on questions from the citizens about what they want to see in the coming year. I think Dan's written a report on that. Pretty good. That's all I had.
Okay. Is there a report on that?
It included something that I do from time to time. It was the update.
Okay.
I can't remember if it was kind of what's happening.
Okay. The only thing I have is I attended a special CASA board meeting yesterday that was only directed to two things, the budget for next year and a discussion about the performance of our executive director. The budget is going to be balanced. It's going to have a little bit from 2018 to carry over, just like we're doing here, and that will balance it out. So there's a minor loss, calculating a minor loss without the adjustment. And then with regard to the performance, obviously, those of you that haven't been involved with CASA as long as I have, you go back to my first meeting was in 91, and CASA was kind of a boring meeting. Just handled a lot of legislation, and every once in a while we had a presentation on some issue. And since we changed the model to be more business oriented, and we hired the executive director, which has now been 5 years, it's changed completely. And my membership has doubled, and the presentations, everybody keeps trying to outdo each other each year with somebody new doing a presentation. So, other than that, there was nothing else discussed, and that's all I got. Okay. Nothing further? My helper over here. At this time, the board will be going into a closed session for the matters described on the agenda under items 10A and 10B. The broadcast will be stopped now, as it is anticipated there will be no report from closed session. Any report will be announced in open session at the end of the meeting. Contact the district secretary during regular business hours if you'd like to find out if there was any information presented. Okay, thank you.
So I'm going to just put it in here and it'll dial you back up on the return.
No, the presentation gets
Actually, I stopped looking at it.
So, like, we're going to be right. sorry I was yours.
Catching happy, your comments.